Good morning and welcome to Roseret Homestead Micro Moment Monday, where today we're going to make good on a promise. First, I want to just make a couple of quick announcements. Thank you so much for all of you who participated in our Black Friday 24-hour sale. It was wonderful. We just were so pleased that so many of you have purchased our books and I hope are enjoying them, helping you to get better prepared. We just appreciate that so very much. The second announcement is I am cleaning up our channel. The way that our channel is organized in playlists is ridiculous. We have about 30 different playlists and they're redundant, they overlap, they're a little bit confusing, and so I'm going to do away with all of the playlists. So I have about a dozen playlists that I'm going to be filing all of our videos in. The videos will all still be there, but the playlists organization is going to be completely different. Hopefully it will be easier for you to locate things. Now for today. 2 months ago when we first started our Level Up Your Food Storage and we talked about having 60 days of meals plus 3 days minimum of water in an integration of our freezer, refrigerator, and pantry, I promised and we set a goal that by Thanksgiving we would have our freezer organized. And we have. In a minute, we're going to go out in the garage and I'm going to show that to you. Today is Thanksgiving Day, so we are actually videoing this on the day we said we would do it. It just won't be published until for a few days over the weekend. So we've got pies in the oven and that sound is competing a little bit with what we're saying. So we are going to head out to the garage and going to explain to you how this has been a life-changing, literally, a life-changing event in our lives and probably in our estimation, one of the most valuable things that we have done on our channel. So let's go out to the garage. So come on in. It's going to be a little darker in the garage and let's take a look at our freezers. So here is our big freezer and I want to show you first on the outside how I have organized this. This has been a real game changer for us. This is my inventory method. And I'm about to finish up the book on 60-day meal prep. It will be launched on sale for Jim's big birthday sale at the end of December. And so you can watch for it then. But I talk in detail about what this is, but I'm going to show it to you right now. So inside the freezer, we have five shelves. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4 is, you'll see in when we get in. And the shelves on my freezer are not adjustable. Wherever they are is where they stay. Each of these pages represents a column of bins. So in the first position, there are 3 bins stacked on top of each other. Beef 1, beef 2, meals 3. And I have listed in the bins exactly what it is. Now, if you can come up really close, so you can see in beef 1, I have taco meat, and here is a 3, a 2, and a 1. So I started off with 3 packages, and Mexican shredded beef, I started off with 2 packages, but I've used 1. And so I have a red pen off here to the side that I just take out. And whenever any of us gets anything out of the freezer, we cross off one of those cells. So I now know I have only 1 Mexican shredded beef left, and we started with 5, but I now only have 4 hamburger and onions. So in the second position is meals 1 and breakfasts. And then in the third position is meals 2, and you'll see why we only have 1 there in just a minute. On the next shelf is meals 4, chicken 1, veggie 1, 2, 3, veggie 4, 5, 6, pork 1, 2, 3, this row is empty, and then pork 4 and pork 5 are down here. So let's take a look inside so you can see how I have organized these. So here's meals 3, beef 2, beef 1. Here's meals 1, and here's breakfast. Now in each one of these, I have, these are individual meals. So here is a chicken rice casserole, and then I have 3 turkey and gravies, and they are ready to go. For meals 2, I do these in full gallon bags. Here I have chicken one, and these were the chicken chunks that I did in the Costco rotisserie chicken. We started with five, I now only have four left. Time to do some more. And it goes that way continuously. On the bottom shelf, I have big things. We just found a great buy on a turkey. So there's a turkey here, and here's some ice stuff here with pork four and five. Then in this empty shelf, it isn't quite empty. I'm still figuring out a way to label these, but I have tamales sauce, pizza sauce, and a couple of packets of chicken broth that are standing up right here. So we are constrained with our space, and but this organization is just so phenomenal. And then on the door, I just have some other things that help support our meals. Now here, almost the same week that we started this project 2 months ago, we happened to be in Costco, and I walked by these little freezers. I could not believe it. These are phenomenal. $350 for a small size freezer, and in that freezer there are bins. Everything is in a bin, and I have labeled them drawer one through drawer seven. And there are things such as, here is some beef steak strips, I have beef stew meat, I have some raw hamburgers right here ready to go. So this is our bulk. Here is shrimp. Here is breads. I have tortillas and rolls. And so here is my inventory for this. Drawer one has chicken tenders. Drawer two has chicken breasts. I started off with 14. You can see how many I have used. Drawer three is beef and hamburgers. I started off with nine. I still have nine. Pork chunks, drawer four. I have pork chops, tenderloin, country ribs, and a five-pound boneless shoulder. And then the remaining ones. My mushrooms are down here, and I have some raw eggs that I have frozen. And so this is our organization for our meals. We now have 60 days of meals between these two freezers, probably more. But I've made a menu, I've made my list, it will be in the book that we're going to publish. But this has helped me so much be more organized with my meal prep and keeping track of the foods that we have. And so I hope this little introduction to how we've organized our freezer and how we're doing the inventory might be helpful to those of you who are still struggling. In terms of chest freezers, I don't know. Those of you that have chest freezers, if you have figured out a good way to organize that may be similar to this, please share it so the rest of people with chest freezers will be able to benefit from a lot of other comments from people who have organized. So this is a great help for us in terms of our level one preparation with the integration of our freezer, refrigerator, and pantry. So now that we've seen this out here, I'm going to pull some of the bins and take them in the house and give you a closer look at some of the things that we've done with our bins. So I have pulled four bins, two from the big freezer, two from the little freezer, so that we can get a better idea of what are some of the things are that that we have done. First of all, we've had a lot of people say, we need to know how to prepare for just one person or just for the two of us. And so this is a way that addresses that very situation. All through the book that will be published for Jim's birthday sale, I talk about buy big, package small, or make big batch things and then package them small. And how small depends on how small your family is or how large your family is. And I would do things very different if I was still at home with my six children than I'm doing now with just the two of us. And so this is such a versatile way of approaching organization that you can just fit it to whatever your individual needs might be. So these two are meals. Now I've frozen meals. I've also frozen lots of individual ingredients, and you'll see. So I make a big batch, and then I freeze up leftovers. So here is chicken tortilla soup. Here is taco soup. Here is meatball tortellini soup. Another meatball tortellini soup. This is beef stew and ragu. Every one of these is a full meal. Some of them would go over rice, so I would just need to thaw and cook the rice and I would be done. Others are just a soup that would go with a nice slice of homemade bread after being heated up. So these are so convenient, and freezing them flat like this, I lay them out in our sunny windowsill over here that faces south, and these are thawed in about a half an hour. And so it makes them very, very easy to work with. I wish you were here in our house right now. It smells so wonderful. I just took pies out. Turkey will go in just a few minutes. I love the smells of cooking on Thanksgiving Day. That bin and this bin were the same size, but notice that the packages stuck up above the lid level, so I couldn't put a lid on, and the same is true here. Now, most of those meals, in fact, all of those meals, most of those meals are recipes from our new book coming out, so you can have those recipes. So is this one. I made a huge lasagna, and these are, I have 5 packages of individual servings of lasagna. And so these also thaw quickly, and I can just pop this right in the microwave, and we're ready for dinner. And then back here, I have, this was such a good dinner. Look at this. This is a tortilla dump dinner, all cheesy on the top with onions and cilantro. And so this is for two of us, and this is for two of us. So again, these were leftovers from meals, the recipes of which will be in our new book. And so make big batch things and then freeze them in the size that works for your family. Now these two bins represent more individual ingredients that I build a meal from rather than having a meal to just take out. So this is our beef drawer. And the other day we got a great big old amount of hamburger, and Jim spiced it all up the way he loves to spice up hamburgers with Traeger spice mixes and so forth. And then we have this handy dandy little hamburger shaper thing, and this is in our Amazon store for anybody who might be interested to check it out. And so I have a lot of hamburgers, well, I think 9 hamburgers that are spiced and ready. They just need to be thawed, and then they can be put right on the grill. They are ready to go. So then at our favorite restaurant store, we bought some great big chunks of meat. The prices there are really good. This is pork chunks, this is stew meat, and these were frozen. I diced these or cubed them and put them out on our baking sheet and froze them on that baking sheet individually, and then put them in here so now I can just grab whatever I want. More stew meat, and then some steak strips that are perfect for lasagna. And steak strips that are perfect for
stroganoff.
Thank you. For beef stroganoff. That's what these are for, not lasagna. Then, this one just started out on a whim, but it has been one of the most successful things that I have done to help streamline meal preparation. We do a lot of things with tortillas, and I'm always asking if Jim can please pick up a package of tortillas. I didn't even really think too much about freezing them in advance, but now we have both corn and flour tortillas in the freezer. It has made such a difference. I can open up any one of these, repackage them in a plastic bag, or these have a little Ziploc bag, and once they're here and then inside these bins, it does protect them from freezer burn. But then I can just pull out the number of tortillas that I need instead of having to deal with the whole package. And then I expanded that. I decided that I would start baking. I have a recipe in our bread book that is hamburger buns. And so I made a great big batch of hamburger buns, and I'm packaging them in bags of 4. And so that way, I don't have to, if I think, oh, tonight I want to have pulled pork sandwiches and I don't have any buns, and so I have to make a big batch of buns, that idea of having to put the bread together, make that bread, would almost make me decide to serve something else. But having them in the freezer so that all I have to do is pull them and they thaw in 15 minutes and the buns are ready, all I have to do is go get some of our barbecued beef packets or our spicy pork packets and thaw those, and with this, then I have a nice dinner. And then I have made a big batch of our honey wheat rolls, which I package up in packages of six. So I have buns and rolls along with the tortillas here as individual ingredients or individual meal accompaniments that has worked really, really well for us. So that's kind of a peek at what we have done. There's a lot more out there, but I'm hoping that you get the idea so that you can implement this according to how you see it and how it works best for you. But this is a phenomenal way to be organized with meals and to be prepared for level one immediate with our 60 days of meals by integrating our freezer, refrigerator, and pantry. And when that book comes out, you will check out what in the appendix I have a list of what our 60 days of meals are, and you will recognize them as being things that we have shown you today. Many of them I will just pull right from what I've shown you today. So thank you for being with us. We're happy to share this, and I hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving. So we will see you again very soon for another video.